Friends, my name is Robert Tickner, the CEO of Australian Red Cross, and I've been asked to say a few words today before I introduce Mr. Romano from the Japanese embassy to officially open the exhibition. I think the first thing to say is to thank the Chief Justice and the High Court for their courtesy in allowing this event to be held in the High Court foyer today. I think what a fitting place it is to hold an event of this kind. The High Court, of course, is associated with the rule of law, with principles, with values, with holding governments to account on occasions. It's one of the institutions that make up the fabric of this great country that we have. And it's wonderful that the High Court has supported the holding of this very non-controversial but very powerful event here today. I think my starting point for commenting on our reason for being here is to say that if the High Court embodies so much of the decency and principle and rule of law that we hold dear, nuclear weapons probably embody and are a manifestation of one of the great evils of the world. And it's an evil which, of course, is very much present in our lives, even though many of us forget how present that threat is. There has been, of course, a vast horizontal proliferation of nuclear weapons. The threat is always there of nuclear weapons getting into the hands of non-state actors. The threat of an accidental detonation of a nuclear weapon is always there. The consequences, of course, are not just horrific immediate loss of human life, as cataclysmic as that might be, but it's also the threat of a global environmental disaster, such as the world has not known in our lifetimes or the lifetimes of many generations before. But as we stand here in Australia, in our peaceful country, we have to face a very stark reality in international law. And that is that while the international community has acted laudably, often with Australian government support, with various governments of different political persuasions, to take action on issues like chemical and biological weapons, although we've acted on the scourge of landmines and cluster munitions, the fact of the matter is, as we stand here today, the use of nuclear weapons is not definitively prohibited under international law as an illegal weapon of war. That sounds extraordinary, doesn't it? And it's because it is so extraordinary that the movement that has started now so powerfully with the support of Red Cross to have some international convention to render the use of nuclear weapons illegal under international law is truly, I believe, an idea whose time has come. And why should Red Cross, the Australian Red Cross, the Japanese Red Cross, and a very large number of Red Cross and Red Crescent societies around the world, why should we be joining now shoulder to shoulder with the International Committee of the Red Cross to spearhead this campaign for some convention to render the use of nuclear weapons illegal? Why should we be doing that? Well, the answer is in our very origins. The answer lies in some ways in the principles that were enunciated and driven by the person who conceived the idea of Red Cross way back in 1859 in a battlefield in Italy called Solferino. Because Henri Dunant, the person who's awarded the first Nobel Prize for his contribution to the creation of Red Cross, put forward some fundamental key principles, if you like, which have indeed transformed human thinking. He first of all said that there ought to be laws of war, and I'll turn to that again in a moment. But he also said that there should be Red Cross societies around the world, volunteers, people who would render assistance to those on the battlefield. And indeed, that thought gave rise to the great global movement of Red Cross and Red Crescent that we see today, not just involved in issues of war and peace and conflict, but humanitarian affairs, development affairs, the response to natural disasters. But to go back to the other principle that Henri Dunant stood for, it was that there ought to be limits to human suffering. In the barbarism of the world and in human conflict, that there had to be a line which should not be crossed. And one of those lines was the protection of civilians who might be impacted by conflict. People like the young students who are here today, the kids who are here today, they should not be targeted in war. But of course, they are only one example of civilians who should not be targeted, and there are many more. War is not for civilians. And that principle was, of course, reflected in the first Geneva Convention way back in 1864. And it's for those kinds of reasons that Red Cross around the world is stepping up to this issue. Because there is no weapon like a nuclear weapon that is so indiscriminate, that has the capacity to kill in the current context of the world's weaponry, literally has the capacity to obliterate large sections of the world population. It is an abhorrent weapon, and that is why the International Red Cross and Red Crescent movement is embarking upon, with the support of many other people who've been working in this space for many decades, is now making its contribution to the international debate around the illegality of nuclear weapons. What I'm pleased to report to you is that the momentum is growing. From a resolution passed at the General Assembly, at the Council of Delegates of the International Red Cross and Red Crescent in Geneva in 2011, we've seen some wonderful and inspirational developments that have occurred, including a meeting that was held in Oslo earlier this year with 127 governments who came together, believe it or not, for the first time ever in history to discuss the humanitarian consequences of nuclear weapons. The first time. Because all the other meetings that have been held have focused on other things, the politics, you know, the power plays, if you like, around issues of disarmament. But what Red Cross and Red Crescent and the International Committee of the Red Cross has done is bring this back to fundamentals, to raise that question, what would Henri Dunant do in the current context? So we're seeing some very constructive efforts by governments. We're going to see another major conference held by the government of Mexico next year, which I think will be another important step towards some international convention to render the use of nuclear weapons illegal. But let me end on this note, if I could, before I introduce Mr. Romano. You know, in the grand sweep of human history, if you ask what really affects, what really changes the course of history, it is so very often people like you and me, each of us in our own sphere of influence around this world, speaking out, speaking up, speaking constructively with rational persuasion, sometimes with powerful emotion as well, and we shouldn't be ashamed of that when we're talking about nuclear weapons. In other words, through our own efforts, supporting the work of Red Cross, Red Crescent, the International Committee of the Red Cross, we too can be a powerful voice. In Red Cross, we call this the power of humanity. The power of humanity can truly change the course of history. So, to all of you here today, thank you so very much for coming. You have, by your presence, shown your support for what I think is this powerful idea, which can be achieved in a very short period of time, I believe, if we really mobilise that power of humanity.